It's actually 10:15, that is right now, to 11, then 11:10 to 11:55. So till then we'll be having the session, that's our first session. Then 12:55 to 2:35 we'll be having the second session. So what we'll be doing in the first part is introducing the syllabus to you, discussing a few things, what we have, what not, what we need to do about it, that we will discuss. And then we will think of what can be done as to what can we do with reference to our own import. That is, if you look at it, what are the different things that you can think of? Wait a second, just a minute. So yeah, we'll begin there. Okay, so let's begin with your ideas of what do you think the course is all about. The course is known as Communication and Soft Skills, and it's in your fifth sem. Almost you will have one more sem, and then perhaps you, most of you, will be going for your post graduation somewhere, or you'll be trying to get a job. So why this title of the course? Anyone, any ideas? My question is, if it's not clear, let me get more clear. What do you think of the title of this course? Communication and Soft Skills. I mean, these are two things which are like, communication skills is a course that you might have done already. You had done it already in your second sem. It was a theory based course, and you did certain things, and then you wrote an exam on that, and that's all. Soft skills is something that you might have be hearing for a very long time. So now, yes. So just go back to the journey that you had for the past four semesters with us, HSS. So we began with the liberal arts, where some of you took MGD, and some of you took painting and photography. Second sem, communication skills. And third and fourth was CPI and any creativity, problem solving and innovation, and then human values and professional ethics. So this was the journey. Now you think of this, that in these three courses, four courses, five courses that you have gone through with HSS, we've generally been talking from, we've been moving from the individual to the social. So in the liberal arts, it was your individual creative expression which you used to take. It could be through media, it could be through photography, it could be through painting. Then slowly we started moving toward the social, when you see, and even creativity, even communication skills, the course that we did. There, the communication is entirely the way you communicate to a different audience. How do you, what is my language skill? How do I use that language to communicate with people? That's largely what we focus on. So the focus largely on these two courses, both liberal arts and communication skills, has been on the you. That is, how do you respond? What do you do? Then slowly, as we move towards human values and professional ethics and creativity, problem solving and innovation, it's more towards moving from the I towards the we. Okay, it's a good thing that I know painting, but I cannot draw graffitis on public walls. I am a great painter. I do graffiti painting, but it is not that I paint on someone's wall. So I need to understand that my freedom, my communication, my individual thing to liberty has to be done with, has to be linked to society. That what society thinks about it. So they are moving from the society. Now we are moving to the professional level. The two courses that we are going to do, that is in the fifth sem, communication and soft skills, and the second course that you are going to do, contributory personality development, which will come in your sixth sem, is largely about organization. How do I interact and work in an organization? Beginning with what do I do to make myself useful to an organization? Some of you might say ki main koi organization mein kaam nahi karne wala hu, main apna ye karne ke baad M.Tech karunga, lekin kahin na kahin to aap naukri loge. Dusri cheez, if you say that no, I want to join my father's business, my parents' business, that is what I'm going to do, I'm not going to work under someone. Or you might say that I'm not going to work under someone, I'm going to become an entrepreneur. Maine khud ka business start karna. Ye kuch bhi ho, you're still working in a professional environment. More so if you're planning to be entrepreneurs, any of you plan to build, start a startup or work on this, देन द ऑनेस इज मच मोर स्ट्रॉन्गर, बिकॉज किसी के ऑर्गेनाइजेशन में आप काम करते हो, थोड़ा गुगली मार देते हो, थोड़ा गुचा मारते हो, तो फाइन, मतलब द यू आर नॉट एट लॉस. द लॉस, मैक्सिमम लॉस दैट यू विल हैव इज दैट यू लूज योर जॉब. दैट्स द मैक्सिमम लॉस दैट यू विल कम अक्रॉस. बट इफ इट्स योर ऑर्गेनाइजेशन, खुद का स्टार्टअप है, एंड यू lack basic soft skills and communication skills and things like that, it's a loss for you at a very big level, because you've invested money into that startup and things don't go well and you have lost a lot of money. So that is where we think that this course helps you. It's a preparatory course for your jobs. So our focus on in this course will be on improving or to look at how we can be more acceptable to an organization. Kaise karenge, matlab, what is the plan? How do we plan to handle this issue that we call miscommunication, which happens with us on a day-to-day basis, if you look at that, right? So yes, so these are, I thought that this is the best way to begin with the presentation and talk about the barriers to different kinds of. When in the previous SEM, that is when we talked about communication skills, we also talked about why communication is getting affected, because you have several barriers, you have several issues, you have many things that are coming your way. But over here, we're looking at how it can be, how you can use it more effectively in your organization. Organization level, okay. Let's begin with a very simple question here. Very simple question here. Kisi ka video on hai, koi lad raha hai. But theek hai. So let's see. Okay. Now I want all of you to think about one thing. Let's have a discussion on this first before we proceed with the discussion on the syllabus. What, give me one or two or three criterions, two or three factors which you expect from the organization which you're going to be working. I'll put the question. What are your expectations from a job? You may nokri le raha hu. What are your expectations? I'm joining an organization. What are the different things that you expect from the organization?
Good facilities.
Can you explain that a bit? What do you mean by facility?
Means they should provide health insurance and all those things.
They should provide, they should take care of you basically. Okay, fine. What else? So you can say amenities, that is package maybe. You begin here. The pay package, which includes several things, like it should have a decent pay package as per your qualification. And then it should give you a basic, it should pay package. Basically yeah. What you're saying, Amit, this pay package. That it should take care of certain other issues that you have. It should take care of your job security and so on and so forth. So pay package. What else?
Good social environment, so that the people around which we are approachable and social or friendly enough.
Okay. So you need the working environment should not be hostile. A non-hostile. Yes. Working environment. Non-hostile working environment. What else? Well, think. Package hai. Good working environment hai. Theek hai. Working environment, both physical and psychological. Physical, it should not be a startup office or something. It should be a good office. People should not be jerks. They should be people who work together, which is fine. What else? In terms of package, non-hostile working environment, what else? Think, what do you expect from a job? these are what I'm putting before you are expectations from your employer. These expectations are what you think of your what you think from your employer.
Something that values us and can also encourage us further to grow.
Okay, so this is a very important thing. Growth as per your effort, right? Growth as per your effort, that is, I'm putting in efforts, I'm slogging myself, I'm putting in the, if I'm in the right projects and all, and then the growth is there. The growth, I see the growth. Okay, I've been here for 2 years and I've been working. So because of that, there is some growth in terms of, not just in terms of salary, but also in terms of the work that I get to do. It should be at par with my qualification. I might be getting 2 lakh rupees, 3 lakh rupees per month. That's a good pay package. People also treat me well. Lekin main computer engineer hoon. लेकिन मुझे नौकरी दी जा रही है दफ्तर का आई एम आस्क्ड टू जस्ट रिकॉर्ड पीपल्स एंट्री एक्सिट आई एम जस्ट आस्क्ड टू डू बेसिक थिंग्स आई एम आस्क्ड टू डू बेसिक कोडिंग आई एम नॉट गिवन वेरी बिग प्रोजेक्ट्स सो व्हेन योर ग्रोथ इज नॉट हैपनिंग एंड ओके फॉर द फर्स्ट 6 मंथ्स दे केप्ट यू एट द डेस्क दे जस्ट सेड दैट ओके यू डू सर्टेन बेसिक एडमिनिस्ट्रेटिव वर्क एंड यू डू बेसिक कोडिंग थिंग्स यू जस्ट डू दिस यू पुट सर्टेन डेटा हियर एंड देयर एंड प्रिपेयर फाइल्स दैट्स ऑल दैट दे आर आस्किंग यू टू डू एंड यू आर अ कंप्यूटर इंजीनियर यू हैव डन some amount of work in coding. They're not giving it to you for the next two years, then there is no growth. Now, where does growth come from? Growth comes from more challenging or interesting projects. We all hate taking up challenges. We think that we risk bahut hai. But we feel if the company puts you in challenging projects, that is your growth, if you're able to do it well. So some really good projects, some interesting projects that you can work on based on your skill, and also put you with a experienced team. Very important, because you don't learn if, say, I don't know how many of this, I'll link you to link this to video games, which is my area. So I don't know how many of you know about this term. I'm those of you are in video games, you would know about this term called guilds. Kitne log ne suna hai ye? I'm linking it to that. So whenever you take up a video game and you're playing with that game, there is something called guild in that game. That is, it is a kind of a squad that you are there in, and the more powerful squad you are in, the more powerful guild you are in, the more experience points you get in the game. So you go grow up higher. So same is the case in an organization as well. So if you are always with a beginner's team, it is okay. You are with a freshers team. All of you are at the same level, almost. There might be few who are there and not. Clan, yes, clan is there. Some people say guild, some people say it's squad, but the one that I play usually is guild and squad, which I generally use. Clans are also there. But what I'm saying is, this thing works in organizations as well. If you put in a really good team, an experienced team to work with, then what happens is that you may make mistakes, you may have problems, but there is always ways that the experienced team helps you out. If you are a novice team, that is, you are all freshers. Sab log freshers ho, ek project diya gaya hai. And the company itni bewakoof bhi nahi hai ki aapko ek bada project de, if you are a new person. So this is the tendency which you see in companies, that they generally put you with an experienced team. Although it is a headache for the experienced team members, because they will have to tutor you and mentor you in different places. But slowly you start learning, because you see them work. Now there is something that is there. So the experience team hai, guilds and squads are challenging projects. Package is of course there that people look at. Non-hostile working environment is there, fine. You cannot wish away politics within an organization. It's always there, so you can't do anything about it. But what happens is, say for example, we meet over tea, or when we meet, we are constantly chattering about outside, complaining. So there is a lot of non-hostile, से मैं कहूँगा ki what kind of a team do you have? Do you have a team which is negative in nature? So something of some kind of positive thing, that you need a positive team. So these are things which you expect from the organization, that it should be a, generally it should have good pay package, non-hostile, there should be a cool working environment, the growth should be as per your effort, you should be a part of, not initially though, but later on you should be part of challenging projects, you should be given chance to work with the big guys, that is the experienced team, so that you learn. There are chances that the experienced team might not accept you, वो कहेंगे इसको मेरे टीम में मत रखो क्योंकि हमें इनको ट्यूटर करने का टाइम नहीं है बट जनरली व्हाट कंपनीज डू इज दैट ये सब नहीं चलेगा बिकॉज व्हेन यू जॉइन द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन वी डिड द सेम टू यू आई कैन नॉट विश फॉर दैट व्हेन अ पर्सन जॉइन्स माय ऑर्गेनाइजेशन ये इसको मेरे साथ मत रखो मेरा दिमाग बहुत खाता है और मैं जो कर रहा हूँ मैं अपने पेस में बहुत स्पीड में काम कर रहा हूँ ही इज पुलिंग मी डाउन यू कांट से दैट टू द टीम मैनेजर बिकॉज व्हेन यू आर अ सीनियर expected to tutor or mentor the junior members who join the company and help them to grow. So,
but actually wo to organizations enforce those things na so that what if that guy who is more experienced would be elevated to some other to some next level or maybe is extradited to some other company then the next one should be there in pipeline na so that is why even the organizations enforce those things
but they don't do it at times वो लोग क्या करते हैं कि बिकॉज दे बिलीव दैट बाय पुटिंग अ नोविस और अ यंगस्टर और एन इंटर्न विद एन एक्सपीरियंस टीम दे फील दैट इफ द टीम इज गोइंग टू सफर बिकॉज ऑफ दैट बिकॉज यू नो मेंटरिंग इज अ वेरी डिफिकल्ट टास्क यू सम ऑफ यू हु हैव गॉट ब्रदर्स एंड सिस्टर्स यू माइट नोटिस द ट्रेनिंग इज अ वेरी इज अ डिफिकल्ट थिंग एंड पीपल नीड टू इन्वेस्ट टाइम इन ट्रेनिंग पीपल एंड लेट बी ऑनेस्ट विथ यू दैट दिस एचआर ट्रेनिंग्स एंड ऑल दीज थिंग्स आर ऑफ नो यूज because you don't get that kind of training from places aap kaam karoge to aapko training zyada milega the more you are in a situation the thing that we learn from the most in organizations ho ya kahin par bhi ho they are from
but what you are saying what if so you are saying that what if the organization does not enforce those things but in that case the organization itself suffers because a they would have to get those people get those experienced guys from some other organization so obviously they'll have to pay more and plus there would be a distrust among the lower side of the organization so those who are a little bit less experienced because they'll feel that they should have been elevated to the next level whereas someone else who is not from the organization is coming back
yeah that's true Dhruvil. Actually I said matlab organizations generally do that kind of a thing when you look at they generally put you in certain challenging they might what happens is that this is on one side they believe such kinds of things can happen second they're also you may be working on a project which has zero margin of errors there is no chance for an error so they would not put interns in that team they'll put experienced people in that team but what happens in many companies is that they put youngsters in the deadline based high achieving teams as well wo kabhi kabhi karte hain kabhi nahi karte hain tabhi ye karte hain ki because we don't want to risk it so wait karo we'll give them a smaller project we'll put them with the experienced team but we'll give them a project where the stakes are not very high because the company doesn't ye such hai ki experience
wale so like what to at the end of the day her organization pnl to dekhega hi na apna wo to profit and loss to dekhega hi but obviously wo dono ek matlab they'll have to look at both of those aspects simultaneously so to say they'll clearly look at their profit and loss so whatever you are saying that they'll look at they'll push you into those circumstances but they'll also push you into those circumstances when the stakes are low clearly because they don't want to risk themselves also with their clients as well and they also don't want to risk their less experienced guys confidence as well so those are also the things that
something that happens in organization so yeah, yes yeah. You have and even if you're an intern and you start working as in an experienced team the one that teaches you the most is what I have mentioned failures and errors that happen in many places that there are times when you decide to do something and it does not go as expected so you learn more from these things जैसे फॉर एग्जाम्पल यू राइट यू अपने क्लास के बारे में ही सोच लो कि यू गिव अ क्विज एंड यू थिंक दैट दिस वाज द आंसर एंड यू गिव द क्विज एंड देन फाइनली यू फाइंड आउट दैट नो इट वाज रॉन्ग परहैप्स देन द आंसर वाज रॉन्ग एंड बिकॉज ऑफ दैट यू लॉस्ट मार्क्स आई थिंक यू विल नेवर फॉरगेट व्हाट वाज दैट आंसर एवर इन योर लाइफ अगेन बिकॉज गलती से सीखे हो और आपने मार्क्स खोए हैं उसके लिए सो देयर आर थिंग्स But there are several things in organizations which happen. There is a something which happens generally, which we call this one. You heard of this term, glass ceiling, which means that this is generally for that the growth opportunities. That is there a faster growth? I'm working very hard, but then I'm not getting the requisite promotions. But it's taking too long for me. There is a huge line, and that huge line, they're doing it according to hierarchy than performance. So there are organizations which do that as well. This we understand.
In those cases, the organizations where those hierarchies are very much so they follow those hierarchies tightly, they suffer a huge losses.
Yes.
To be remembered, DRDO and BARC are huge losses in this country because they are run by those hierarchies rather than being center of excellences.
Yeah.
They call themselves one, but they aren't.
They aren't, yes. Another one which you can think of is the famous PNB case, if any of you are aware of this. The PNB scam, Nirav Modi wala. Ye hierarchy versus performance pe zyada hai. Anyone knows what really happened because this is about organizations, we are talking about it, and then we'll go into how this is going to, how you are going to be of use to the organization in a larger way. The PNB scam, the Punjab National Bank scam, which Nirav Modi took a lot of money and fled India. Do you know what really happened? It's because of this error, because of this problem of hierarchy and performance. The LOUs, that is letter of undertaking, which are given, are always sanctioned by senior managers. They're always sanctioned by senior managers. And the senior managers are those people who have been there in the company for a very long, in the bank for a very long time. So such a long time that they are the people who finally give the LOU. The scrutiny happens at the senior managerial level, not at the, there is no scrutiny at the senior level. So then these people were there for many years now and they were not growth. So the junior managers were getting frustrated. Once they became the senior managers in that place, they started thinking that itne saalo se to hum yahan apna kaam kar rahe hain, we are never getting a growth. So let us make the maximum. So LOU gives the maximum. You have to issue a letter of undertaking to the particular client, whoever takes loans from you. There were three managers who were responsible for this in the PNB scam. If you look online, you'll find out more about it. They were in the complete, they were the people who were under the, who had the complete control. Jiski wajah se kya hua ki they started getting an idea that this Nirav Modi is paying us enough. So let's give him the LOU. They bypassed many rules and that led to the major scam. So that is the main issue. Similarly, in organizations also, I have many examples which I know of, where people leave organizations and go to other organizations to work. Famous companies like ITC or Godrej or even many famous companies in India. There are people like even software companies like Wipro and even Dell and many other companies where people work in. There also you will find that this kind of thing is happening. Why are people switching jobs? If you look at the rate of switching jobs among people, you will find that this is because of this hierarchy versus performance issue. Wait a minute. Yes, there's a huge enforcement deficit. Yes. But what happens is that it is a largely, if you look at the case, there is a lot of pressure on the top. So now we have been talking about your expectations. And largely what we expect from the organization when we join. Now what we are going to look at next, and that's where our course also comes in, is what is the organization looking for? So we can broadly categorize it into this, which we call the employability skills. That is skills that get you employed, that make you employable. It's a framework which is used by, which is created by many famous people. So if you look at it, look at this thing that I put in front of you, we will be looking through a few things before. We'll be looking at this and then discussing the syllabus. So just look at this and you will find that yes, communication skills is an important part, but it's not just the part where employability, as far as employability is concerned. We believe communication is key. Yes, it's important. Yes, you need to communicate well. There are several things which are there. All are okay. But yet, the other things are there. So would you, can just take a minute to go through these small little spheres that I've, whatever I can call it, to see what you can, what are the different things that employability skill framework talks about. And then below, we have computing and numerical skills, numeracy, numerical literacy, as we call it. Numerical literacy is this, that it doesn't mean that you need to know complicated calculus and trigonometry and all those things. These computer literacy and numeracy are generally tested in aptitude tests. So if you are appearing for aptitude tests, which is a part of nowadays recruitment, your numerical skills get tested. Quick thinking, because you have less than a minute to solve questions related to numbers. Questions, there are several things, like you have mensurations, you have volume surface area, you have radicals, indices search, and several other things which are related to this aptitude thing. You have many other, you have even calendar, you have clock, you have distance, you have many things which you need to answer, logarithms which are there, and you need to learn all of them. Apart from, there's only a small portion which focuses on language, like verbal reasoning, reading comprehension. These are some of the things which are there. And even reading comprehension, even if you're asked this particular test on reading comprehension, it is not your communication-based reading comprehension. It is a logic-based reading comprehension. So there's a passage which is given to you, and there are some questions. But if you look at the questions, if any of you have been preparing for aptitude, you would realize that the questions are not reading comprehension, that did you understand the passage, what do you mean by who said what, and all those things. They are not, such childish questions are not asked. They want to look at a higher level of thinking, that when I read something, am I able to retain it? Am I able to understand it? Am I able to draw logical inferences out of it? So the numeracy part looks at the logic, that how logical this person is. Is the person streamlined in such a way that the person understands these things? Uske liye aptitude tests aur baki sab aap karte ho, which placement studies also offer. You get to know quick mathematics. There are tricks which are used, like Vedic mathematics is one good example where it teaches you to do things fast. Even if you don't know Vedic mathematic techniques, you are expected to work fast. You don't have time to go to a calculator at times. Now, even when you join your organization and start working, numeracy is one thing which the organization prizes, because every time I can't run to a calculator to calculate, I'll have to do mental mathematics. So if a person says that there's a project and there's a thing that is coming up and we will give you 30% share, you need to see what the company total profit shares are. Of this, you are getting 30%. So what is 30% of that? You can't really rely on it. Okay, so it is around 2 crores, and then 2 crores ka 30%. Itna karke calculator mein calculate karne ka time nahi hota. Because you're sitting in front of someone, you're sitting in front of a client, and they say, we'll offer you 30%. That's all we can offer you. This is other hum offer nahi kar sakte, because humare liye ye loss hai. So you'll have to calculate how much they're making, how much you are making, and then a deal needs to be struck. You cannot say, let me go back and calculate and then get back to you, or open an Excel sheet and look at it. No. So basic percentages, ratios, things should be clear in your head. This is one expectation by the organization. They should know, they should have a very good sense of numerical skills. In the sense, I don't expect you to do calculus and complicated calculations like that. They don't expect you to be a mathematical genius. No. What they expect is that basic mathematics, thinking on the spot, doing basic calculations, drawing inferences. This is something which they expect by numeracy, numeracy-based skills. The second is computer literacy. Now, we all are good at it, and I think the companies also know that we are born with computers. We use laptops, mobile phones. At the time we are kids, we know several things. But what happens is, when it has to be put into a format. जैसे वर्ड है, पावर पॉइंट है, एक्सेल है. दीज आर द थ्री थिंग्स व्हिच जनरली पीपल यूज. सम पीपल यूज टैली एज़ वेल. सो दिस इज माइक्रोसॉफ्ट ऑफिस और एक्सेस. माइक्रोसॉफ्ट एक्सेस इज वन अनदर थिंग व्हिच पीपल यूज. देयर आर पीपल हु यूज दैट फॉर कंप्यूटेशन पर्पसेस. आई नो वर्ड, आई नो एक्सेल, आई नो पावर पॉइंट, बट आई नो हाउ, डू आई नो हाउ टू यूज इट प्रॉपरली? दैट इज, डू आई नो द फंक्शंस क्लियरली? डू आई नीड टू गूगल टू फाइंड आउट हाउ टू फ्रीज अ सेल? डू आई नीड टू नो व्हाट आर द फंक्शंस दैट आई नीड टू क्रिएट अ कैश फ्लो? How do I, what is the formula? If the formula is not readily available or it is not available in that sheet, do I know how to put a round out? How do I create a loop? So these things are all should be on the tip of your fingers, which is expected from a which is expected from anyone. So computer based skills, coming to Word documents. All of us know how to use Word, but think about it that you need one page in landscape and the other page in portrait. And then again, after three pages, you again need it in landscape. And you all need all the pages to be aligned properly. You need this. You need to prepare a report. So when you put a cash flow, when you put a cash flow statement, it has to be in the landscape. So are we good with the aesthetic part of it? Do we know how to use Word properly? ये है कि हम लोग Word में basically assignments type करते हैं और करते हैं. But do we know the basics of that? So what do I do to merge a particular document? How do I do? So you're all computer science students. You know this. Agreed. But generally, company expects you to know it well, because they won't. If you don't prepare a cash flow or certain things properly, if you don't present your Word document properly, if you're not presenting a PowerPoint properly, we have a session on preparing effective presentations. We'll come to that later. But if you don't prepare your PowerPoint properly, if you don't make it presentable, they won't think that this guy does not know how to use Excel. They will only see that this person is careless. ये नहीं कहेंगे कि आपने अगर language errors की है communication में. कोई ये नहीं कहेगा कि इसको लिखना नहीं आता. कोई सब लोग यही कहेंगे कि दिस पर्सन इज केयरलेस. एंड व्हिच इज अ केयरलेस है तो हमारे चीजों को मतलब ही लुक डजंट ही और शी डज नॉट लुक एट इट इन द वे इट शुड बी सीन. सो दैट इज व्हाट दे लुक एट. दे आर नॉट लुकिंग एट इट फ्रॉम. सो न्यूमरेसी एंड कंप्यूटर स्किल्स आर टू थिंग्स व्हिच आर एक्सपेक्टेशंस व्हिच आर एम्प्लॉयबिलिटी स्किल बेस्ड थिंग्स व्हिच वी आर. Employability skill based thing. So yeah, these are two. Then communication skills we have talked about. We will be talking about it in detail. The other things that I have been mentioning here would like if say for example, I'm not going to discuss critical thinking and problem solving because this has already been discussed in your SEM. You have done an entire course on that, so I'm not going to talk about that. We will be talking about ability to manage ourselves, learning to adapt, lateral thinking, organization skills, business and commercial awareness, and teamwork. So these aspects are which is a part of the employability skill framework, which is, if you ask me, these are the skills that we talked about: computing skills and numerical skills. So that's over. This is based. So it's at the lowest rung of our skill based thing. Top में सबसे ऊपर आएगा communication skills, which is important, which is very important. Apart from that, the other three or four spheres, yellow, green, whatever spheres that are there, they are the ones that an employer generally looks. Say there is something. There was a report by some, I don't know when it was released, I forgot the name, but it says that at least 50%, 50 is upper, I'm being a little generous here, 50% says other say come is other low graduates in India or in the world are unemployable. When you say unemployable, it doesn't mean you don't have the marks. It doesn't mean you don't have the percentage or you are a poor performer in academics. Employable means these things: ability to manage yourself, ability to learn, organizational skills, if any. How do you know that? How do you handle an org? If you're given a portfolio, if you're given a portfolio of handling a team, how will you do? Will you be able to do that? You say I'm good as a team player. I'm good at following orders, but I cannot be a team leader. Then business and commercial awareness, we'll come to that in a second. Lateral thinking, I mean, by lateral thinking, they mean rather is to thinking on your feet. If you are in a particular situation and you have to take a decision, every time you can't run to your superiors asking them ki main kya karu. That is lateral thinking, and this is expected. इट्स दैट द बॉस माइट बी देयर टू हेल्प यू आउट, द पर्सन मस्ट बी नाइस. अब जाके पूछोगे तो बोलेगा हमेशा मेरे पास क्यों आते हो, खुद भी थोड़ा सोचा करो बोलेगा, लेकिन द पर्सन माइट हेल्प यू. नाउ व्हाई डू पीपल डोंट टेक डिसीजंस ऑन देयर ओन इज अ मेजर क्वेश्चन हियर. लैटरल थिंकिंग हैज टू डू विद दैट. Why do people don't take decisions on their own? Because there is a lot of risk involved in it. मेरे सामने एक problem है, उसका solution मैं जानता हूँ. But if I take a decision, I am responsible for that decision. So at that point in time, if I take a decision and it falls flat, there are times you have bad luck. You take a decision and it falls flat, there is a problem. Then people will blame you. कि आपने ऐसा क्यों किया? If you are ready to take that risk, it's an initiative. It's a part of initiative that okay. I'm going to take this decision. Come what may, main aise sambhalunga. Maximum we learn from errors, as I mentioned. So we take a decision, we think that this is the best decision at this point in time. I took it, but then it fell flat. Or if it works out, everyone will congratulate you. Wah, kya badhiya socha hai aapne. Lekin agar nahi hota hai, to sab aapke piche pade honge. Ki, so pooch liya hota, bata dete. This is how world is. If you're successful, people will applaud you. If you're unsuccessful, people, all the people who are there with you, including your friends and whoever there, will start condemning you. So, ye hai. So that is why people don't take such responsibilities. They're afraid ki agar fail hua to. So this is lateral thinking comes here, that am I able to take decisions on my feet? If I have a problem, I don't want to run to my boss. I take the decisions on my own. Are you good at that? Taking decisions on your own, taking responsibility for those decisions and moving ahead with it. Then you have ability to learn and adapt, which is a very important thing. I told you when we started the class, I told you that about teams, that we all are, when you join an organization, you might be put with a experienced team and you are the only research intern or a person who is just a fresh graduate in that particular team. I'll share one example with you on this. This is something which is followed in Infosys. Years ago, Infosys had this hierarchy issue. What happened is that when juniors joined the organization and they were made team members in a particular, in a high performing team, their ideas were never accepted. All the time the senior members used to say ki acha acha theek hai karke chhod dete. They never used to listen to the interns, which resulted in that the interns might have, or the person who is joining, the fresher, might have great ideas, but what happens is the seniors don't listen to them. And finally, kya hota hai ki they do whatever they want to do and it ends up being problematic. So when Narayan Murthy got to know of this, he started a new thing. You might be aware of this. He started a leadership institute in Infosys, the first in the country to start a leadership institute. What they do in the recruitment process nowadays is that whenever there's a recruitment, they ask the freshers to come and present before the entire company. So all the senior members, everyone comes and sits in front of them and they sit and listen to this person, whoever it may be. There might be a junior who is presenting his school, a college project or something that they have done. So which is helpful because it helps me decide, okay, this person is really good. And to get into Infosys is a big nightmare. So people who are really the really good, they only make it into the team that you all know of. So wo hai. तो वहां मिलना बहुत बड़ी बात होती है, लेकिन मिल जाता है तो देन यू गेट अ चांस टू प्रेजेंट बिफोर द एंटायर टीम. नरेंद्र मोदी इंस्टीट्यूटेड एट दैट पॉइंट इन टाइम कि ऑल द सीनियर मैनेजर्स एंड पीपल विल सिट एंड लिसन टू द जूनियर हूएवर हैज कम टू प्रेजेंट. इन दैट केस यू लर्न, मतलब इफ ही हैज समथिंग न्यू टू ऑफर, यू हैव बीन यूजिंग अ टेक्नोलॉजी फॉर द पास्ट 10 इयर्स, सम हियर इज अ गाय हु इज टेलिंग दैट दिस टेक्नोलॉजी हैज बीन अपग्रेडेड एंड यू कैन यूज दिस टेक्नोलॉजी कीप्स चेंजिंग एवरी डे. Every possible day, you will have a new thing which is there in the market. It's technology is like that. So this person has brought in a new vision to the company. That person is, so you get to know from the project whether the person is a good communicator, how is he, you'll know from the language, you'll know what kind of exposure that this man, whoever the student, whoever the fresher is, has learned. So in that way, they get to respect the work that the research intern has come. So the next time, when the research intern comes with an idea, or the person who's the intern or the person who is coming with an idea says that, sir, I have an idea, the company people would listen to. Okay, maine iska presentation suna tha, ye acha hai, ye nahi hai ki isko experience chahiye, experience acha hoga lekin ye kaam karta hai, he has done a lot of work and I've seen his project, so let's give him a chance to listen to. Ye bolo karne mein, The other thing which people generally do, in this is one example which is there, that is not when we started. It's about that. You're giving the interns a chance to prove themselves. You're giving the new people a chance to work. And earlier in Infosys and in Wipro and any other companies, people used to leave the companies just because of this reason. That they used to say that we are put in a team, we have a group of senior managers, and the senior managers don't listen to us. They say, you are too inexperienced, we are not going to listen to you. Tum wo karo jo hum karte hain. Saalon se hum log ye karte aaye hain, tum wo karo. Just do what we ask you to do. Many people leave the organization because of that, and they lost good people. So because of that, many companies have now started doing this. They say you upgrade or then you are out. So when a new person comes into the company and offers a new technology or a new way of looking at particular things, learn from them. We don't know many things. Like there were several classes which were taken not on technology, but there was a person who came and taught a lecture on marketing. There was a person who came and gave a presentation on selling, sales. Sales kaise kiya jata hai. So people like Narayan Murthy used to go and sit down and listen to him. Now the person who is coming to say, as I told you, wo bacche aise nahi hote hain ki Infosys mein milna hai, to matlab they need to be really good. Their projects has to be really good. So they will give a fresh perspective to certain things. The company benefits and you get a better rapport. So this is what they do. So now for that to happen, the company expects you to have a different habit, and then you are there in that group. It's always learning on the go for the employee. Is the person ready to learn? So if I'm working in a team and I have senior managers in the team, I'm working with them, am I able to learn? So for example, something happened and the senior managers, the senior people, the senior software analysts, whoever are there, they manage the situation. You know how they manage the situation. You've seen it, how they're doing, kaise kaam kar rahe hain, unhone kaise kaam kiya, unhone kaise is problem ko solve kiya. So you're seeing that and you're learning. So when you're faced with the same situation, do you make the same mistakes or you learn from the other person? Achha, ye pehle hum dekh chuke hain. Inhone kiya tha, inko ye problem hua tha. Why don't I use the same technique? And I learn. Ability to learn and adapt to the organization. This is a very important thing which is expected from any employee. If you don't know technical skills or you don't know skills which are related to your area, it is okay. It's not acceptable, but it's okay because they can teach you that. तो आपको सिखा सकते हैं. लेकिन you say that I know I got an 8-9 CGPA in my graduation and मुझे इन लोगों से ज़्यादा कंप्यूटर और सॉफ्टवेयर कोडिंग आता है. मुझे कौन सिखा सकता है? ऐसे सोचोगे, then that follow when they come to interview you, they will get to know whether you really are you flexible. I have you the ability to learn and adapt to the new situations. Now you look at the new situation that we are facing right now, the COVID situation, wherein many organizations have made work from home. They have made many changes. There's a lot of attrition that is happening. They've changed many portfolios. The earlier portfolios which used to happen before, I know about the hospitality industry, the food industry, because that is one of my pet areas. But I can share that with you. There was a recent, and the film industry, which is happening right now. I'll talk about both, learning to adapt and learn when organization is, I'll give you examples of that. Earlier, whenever there used to be a film shoot, just imagine how many people would be there. Light boys, the light boys, people who carry the light around, do lighting, those people do. Clap ke liye do teen logo ko rakha hoga, giving the clap. Then the costumes, people who prepare the costumes, then the dressers, the choreographers. Choreograph ke saath jo log milke, so with every song you have a group of choreographers who do better anyway than the actor. So these people are there. Then you have a team which takes care of the vanity, the van and all those things. Then you have the director will have some people, assistant director hoga, producer ke saath koi na koi hoga, aise. So team will be close to 100 people, 100 to 200 people anywhere. Now you look at the films that are coming out, they are coming out only, and these all these people need to be paid. Ye nahi hai ki light boy ko assistant director jaisa paisa milta hai, wo nahi, but they are getting paid. You need to pay them 500 rupees, 600 rupees, 1000 rupees, 2000, 3000, jitna pay karna hai, aapko pay karna. You look at today's film shooting, you will see that most of the films being shot today, have got the minimum crew. So there were 10 light boys in previous time. There are only two or three light boys. Stunt masters, one stunt master along with two or three people. Dancers, the choreographer and maybe one or three or four dancers. And maybe they'll bring a few people here and there if it's a group dance. So things have changed. So the people who used to get 3,000, 2,000, 1,500, 2,000 rupees from every shoot have lost their income. So now they need to adapt. Kya kar sakte to live? What can they do? So if the light boy has been doing only lighting for the past 10 years and has never learned how to look after, if the cameraman says that isko lighting ke alawa lensing ke bare mein bhi thoda pata hona chahiye, so I should be able to change. I should be able to learn, because if I'm standing for lighting, I can see how the director is working. I can see how the stunt, several things are happening. So main wo jaan sakta. Some people don't, so they get filled out. They get out of the industry. Same is the case with several, the hospitality industry today. You know, the maximum money that the hospitality industry used to make in most of in hotels and restaurants was through the buffets which they used to keep. क्योंकि उसमें से सबसे ज़्यादा लोग लेते थे और उसमें से फायदा भी होता था. Nowadays people are not, and functions, शादी हो या get together with people. Now you look at the time, people are not. If you look at marriages now. एक तो ये है कि मैरिजेस में लोग ज्यादा जाते नहीं. दूसरा, फूड यूज टू बी अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट एस्पेक्ट ऑफ शादी. शादी वहां हो रही है लेकिन लोग खाने के लिए बैठे और खाना लेके दोस्तों के साथ बैठ के खाना खाते हैं. नाउ यू लुक एट हाउ इट इज हैपनिंग. पीपल डोंट वांट फूड. आते हैं मतलब दे वांट, दे कम, दे ईट एंड दे लीव. दैट्स ऑल. दे डोंट वांट टू स्टे टू मच टाइम. दे हैव द फियर ऑफ गेटिंग इन्फेक्टेड. सो व्हाट हैज हैपेंड इज यू जस्ट हैव वन पर्सन टू. होटल्स हैव स्टार्टेड हैविंग होम डिलीवरी services, delivery services. So what has changed? Waiters, they have lost the job. So ek do honge jo baithe honge counter pe, andar ek chef hoga, ya maybe one person to help that person, and just one person to deliver the thing from there laake bas deliver karne ke liye. Baaki logon ki naukri kahan gayi? What is happening is, if you are stuck to the kind of jobs that you've been doing for the next 10 years, for the past 10 years, 15 years, you have not learned anything. Aapke field out hone ke chances badh jate. And things are changing. So this is one thing which the organization looks for. Ki I employed you as a software engineer. Can you also do administrative work? Can you also do the work of a manager? Can you also do some resource management or some pooling, crowdfunding, funding for the organization? Ye aap sab kar paate ho ya nahin? Ye sab cheeze dekhi jati hai. In organizations. We'll stop here for now because there are another 2-3 frameworks that I need to talk to you about. And from with that, I'll take you to the syllabus. I want to show you some stats as well. Okay, what are the employers looking for and where do the graduates lack? This was done by Deutsche Bank in 2019-20. So we'll talk about that. As of now, we'll have a break. We'll stop here for now. You have a break. It's 11:12. Come back around 11:20 and then we'll continue. And then I think your break for this is, I don't know, it's 11:55. So 11:20 tak wapas aa jao, and then we'll finish off the syllabus part, and then in the next class we will start working on the one of the components, start with one of the components of our syllabus, right? So have a break, come back at 11:13, so 11:15, maybe 11:20. You can come back at by 11:20.
Sir, we have expert session at 11:30.
But you have an expert session at 11:30. Okay. And till when it is going to be?
1:30.
Okay. It's going to be so. Okay. Starting at 11:30. Mm-hmm. Okay. So I need to talk to this about this. Otherwise, but it gets over at 1:30. Missing out a huge section. No problem. Let's continue then, because then you need to go at 11:30. I'll talk to your teachers, because this we don't have. We are getting these 2 hours, 4 hours. So skip each me of expert sessions. Okay, you're missing out on lessons. But fine, we'll discuss that later. Fine. Let's continue then, because I'll finish off this part, and then what I'll do is, so let's go ahead. Learn on the go, ability to learn and adapt. what we'll do is I'll finish this and introduce the syllabus to you, and I'll give you a small quiz, which we generally give as a part of my brushing up. It was something you did on communication skills. There are two descriptive things that you need to complete. You complete that, and then we will see after 1:30. We are classed in 2:30, I guess. आपका खत्म करो फिर हम लोग अगर मिल पाते हैं तो मिलते हैं लेकिन अभी हम जरा फास्ट कंटिन्यू करेंगे आफ्टर दैट आई विल गिव यू दिस थिंग टू डू सो लेट्स कंटिन्यू आई टॉक्ड अबाउट लैटरल थिंकिंग आई टॉक्ड अबाउट लर्निंग टू अडैप्ट दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट द वन इन येलो इन द टॉप एबिलिटी टू मैनेज वनसेल्फ व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय एबिलिटी टू मैनेज वनसेल्फ इज दैट ईच वन ऑफ अस हैज अ डिफरेंट टॉलरेंस पॉइंट इफ यू कॉल इट टॉलरेंस पॉइंट दैट हाउ मच हम बर्दाश्त कितना कर सकते हैं सम पीपल बिल्कुल बर्दाश्त नहीं कर सकते कुछ लोग होते हैं जो विच आर एक्सट्रीमली ओके प्रॉब्लम नहीं है जितना भी बोलो आई नो अ पर्सन विच इज जिस दुनिया भर का स्ट्रेस उनके सर पर है लेकिन दैट पर्सन इज ऑलवेज स्माइलिंग ऑलवेज हैप्पी नो प्रॉब्लम वेरी कूल देयर इज नथिंग उसको कुछ नहीं आई नो दैट दैट पर्सन इज गोइंग थ्रू अ लॉट ऑफ ट्रबल But you can see that that person is having a wonderful time, no problems, एकदम happy. उसकी वजह से हम लोग भी happy रहते हैं. Person like that, you think that you are a real inspiration, because इतना सारा problem है, फिर भी आप हंसते हुए you are doing your work. वो कभी complain करते हुए नहीं सुना है that अच्छा इतना सारा काम है, ये भी करना है, वो भी करना है. नहीं, वो शांति से अपना काम कर रहे हैं. And a huge smile on that person's face, which means that person knows how to manage themselves. The person does not buckle under stress. ये काम भी है वो काम भी है मार डालेंगे क्या काम देखे ये सब आ जाता है ना देन इट गेट्स अप लेट मी टेल यू समथिंग हियर इन योर स्कूल एंड कॉलेज लाइफ इफ यू क्रिप क्रिप सीआरआईबी अबाउट एनीथिंग इफ यू क्रिप अबाउट वर्कलोड इफ यू क्रिप अबाउट योर असाइनमेंट्स इफ यू क्रिप अबाउट योर टीचर्स इट्स नॉट गोइंग टू रीच दैट टीचर सुन लेंगे बातें कर लेंगे हो गया चला जाएगा Lekin, if you do that in an organization, if you crip about something, if you crip about your boss's behavior, if you, they should be using the other word bitch, but I'm not using that. I'm using cribbing. I'm bitching about someone, but I'm not using that. It's a bad word. I'm using cribbing. So if I crip about my job, if I crip about the responsibilities, if I crip about the work-life imbalance that I'm currently facing, you might be cribbing that to your friend or a colleague. Now, let me remind you, that in a college you have friends, in an organization you have colleagues. You don't have friends. It's an unfortunate thing, but you don't have friends. Why it is so? Because at the end of the day, if your friend, so-called friend, whom you eat with, whom you are talking to, suta break ke liye jaate ho, saath mein ghar pe ghumte ho, firte ho, given a choice that the friend is told, Yeah, I'll give you a promotion. For that, you need to betray someone, your close friend. Do you think the person will do that? Good friends don't. But there are times jo main promotion ke liye main shayad wo kar bhi hu. That is something which is happening in organizations. So just I'm just saying that do you know how when you creep about someone, किसी के बारे में भी आप बुरा बोलते हो या बोलते हो कि और एनी प्रोजेक्ट के बारे में बोलते हो लाइक लास्ट टू कम ऑन अ संडे एंड यू क्रिप फॉर या संडे को भी नहीं छोड़ते संडे को भी आने को बोलते हैं अगर ये आप अपने दोस्तों को बोलते हो यानी इन द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन देयर आर 99.9% चांसेस दैट द बॉस विल आल्सो गेट टू नो ही माइट नॉट से और टेल एनीथिंग कुछ बोलेगा नहीं लेकिन दैट पर्सन माइंड में वो रहेगा मैंने उसको एक दिन संडे को आने को बोला था और उसने उसके सच के पंचायती की थी कि ये बॉस ऐसा मन में रखेगा वो व्हेनेवर देयर इज अ चांस टू फॉर यू टू डू एनीथिंग सो व्हाट इज हैपनिंग इज यू नेवर नो हाउ योर कम्युनिकेशन विल वर्क सो एक्सटर्नल डिस्प्ले ऑफ एंगर और एनी स्ट्रॉन्ग इमोशन हैप्पीनेस सैडनेस एंगर सच थिंग्स हैव टू बी केप्ट इन कंट्रोल व्हेन यू आर वर्किंग इन एन ऑर्गेनाइजेशन एंड दिस इज समथिंग व्हिच पीपल लुक फॉर व्हेन दे एम्प्लॉय यू इज दिस पर्सन वोलेटाइल और लेवल हेडेड वोलेटाइल है या वो लेवल हेडेड है मतलब ठीक है प्रेशर ले लेगा समझ लेगा उसको गुस्सा भी आ रहा है लेकिन वो बात ठीक से करेगा ही विल वर्क एज अ प्रोफेशनल राइट सो दिस इज समथिंग व्हिच वी कॉल मैनेजिंग वनसेल्फ इट्स अ डिफिकल्ट थिंग टू बी सेट एंड डन देन यू हैव दिस बिजनेस एंड कमर्शियल अवेयरनेस व्हिच इज आई एम लीविंग आउट ऑर्गेनाइजेशनल स्किल्स आई एम नॉट टॉकिंग अबाउट इट वी विल टॉक अबाउट टू बिजनेस एंड कमर्शियल अवेयरनेस what is happening in your industry? Are you abreast with the technology with the thing in your field? Aapke field mein kya chal raha? Like you are DCS, you are software students. Other than big data, Bitcoin, IoT, and AI technology, machine learning. Apart from these things, okay, these are all terms. Now, where is the industry headed towards? Now, because of this pandemic and everything, there is a very strong use of technology. So yes, I agree, there's a very strong use of technology, but where is it headed towards? Kahan ja raha hai? Aur jab main apna graduation khatam karunga aur niklunga yahan se, will I fit into the industry? Maine socha ki main chalo main ek software coder banunga ya hacker banunga, for example, just being a little offlandish here. The hacker banunga. Lekin, once you reach that stage, once you're ready to join the organization, is there a need for a hacker in the industry today? That's just an example. So you took up a particular area. I'm going to talk about my area will be Bitcoin, cryptocurrencies, or encryption, end-to-end encryption. That is my area which I'm going to focus on. But I'm going to be a system analyst, which will look at several things. And coding pe kaam karunga. Aisa matlab aapne socha hoga ki this is the area that I want to go into. If you're not aware, now many things have become obsolete. Many jobs have become obsolete. For example, if you remember your grandfathers and people like them in my grandfather's generation, 10th pass with typewriting and stenography. Stenography is writing in Ohio, so it kalati is 10th pass, typewriting, clear kiya hai, stenography hai, you will get a government job. Two of my uncles were working, now they have retired, were working in courts, district courts. Kya kiya unhone? 10th. Wo bhi ये नहीं है उनका कोई मतलब they have not cleared it with flying colors. They managed to get 40-50%. That's all that they managed to get. Pass हो गए, marks आ गया, decent marks है, ठीक है, 40-50% is decent. हमारे में decent is 80-90%. उस time पे 40-50% था. They cleared typewriting along with that. वो पढ़ाई कर रहे थे उसके साथ उन्होंने typewriting clear किया. 3 levels कुछ होते हैं typewriting के. वो clear किया, stenography सीख लिया, they got a job. Think today. 10th के बाद आपको नौकरी मिलेगी जब आपके पास 50% marks है तो. नहीं मिलेगी. 10th के बाद क्या? ग्रेजुएशन के बाद भी नहीं मिलती है ना. थिंग्स हैव चेंज्ड. सो व्हाट आई एम सेइंग इज बिकॉज़ बिजनेस एंड एनवायरनमेंट विल चेंज. बिजनेस हैज चेंज्ड, कमर्शियल अवेयरनेस हैज चेंज्ड, एवरीथिंग हैज चेंज्ड इन द थिंग. सो दे आर लुकिंग फॉर वेदर यू आर रियली रेडी फॉर द बिजनेस. एम्प्लॉयर्स आर लुकिंग फॉर दैट. क्या आर यू अवेयर ऑफ व्हाट इज हैपनिंग इन द इंडस्ट्री? आर यू अवेयर ऑफ व्हाट वी आर इनटू? देयर आर व्हेन वी डील इंटरव्यूज विद यू, आई विल बी आस्किंग यू दिस क्वेश्चन. Because one of the major questions which the employers ask their candidates is that why should we hire you? Hum tumhe naukri pe kyun rakhe? The answer for that is from the industry. How are you relevant to the industry and the position they are advertising for? You have done your master, you have done your graduation, your master's or whatever in a particular area, but that area is no longer fit in the industry and wo kabhi use hi nahi ho raha industry mein. That has become gone, that has gone because of whatever reason it may be. Could be pandemic, could be recession, could be anything. So are you aware that ye industry, ye jo maine fields choose kiya hai, wo do, and you are aware that it is going to be there for a long time? Like my people in my grandfather's age used to believe that typewriters are going to be there forever. No, with advent of computers and people learning computers, typewriters are no longer needed. पहले क्या होता था कि there used to be need for typewriters. Now no one uses a typewriter, right? That is something which is there, which you must understand कि ऐसा है. Different human developers have different quality, different human. Yeah, Dhruval. But what is happening is this is. I didn't get what you said. You can unmute yourself and explain.
So by human development cycle, I mean that science at that time was restricted and limited to those things, especially like science for the layman. So application of science for the layman, if I may correct myself.
Yeah.
And today it is limited to these things. Now maybe in future, not today, obviously, we might have quantum computers taking leaps and bounds and coming to the layman. directly. So at present, it is only it is a luxury only for large organizations like Google and IBM. Maybe it might come just like we have a personal computer, we might have a personal quantum computer coming into play. So at that time, we are looking at a different human development cycle. Plus, the quality of education is also one thing that was very different. At that point in time, when what you are talking is close to 70 years down the line, India. So that was the time when the Brits had just left. And at that time, the because there was a British influence on our education, it was way more qualitative. Today, it is way more quantitative, and thereby the quality has been reduced to like we
in all the quality. But what I'm trying, the example which I gave you was trying to say that certain professions have become obsolete with what you are saying. With the change in education, with the human development cycle, the development in technology. So this thing is going to be there. So at that point in time, that was great. Now it is no longer there. So today, if you're talking about, you gave a wonderful example about Google and the quantum computers. So by the time you complete your education and you have decided that ye mujhe is area mein jana hai, are you really ready to see that will this field which you're talking about has a future? As a future, it will get obsolete very quickly. Jiska matlab hai ki ab jab company mein jaate ho, every company has a philosophy that, okay, we have this, we stand for this, and this is the technology we are investing in. I'm talking about technology because you're technology students. So, are you really relevant to your job, the job that you're going to take up? Is it relevant to the industry? As far as the industry is concerned, or are you out of your place? Because by the time you complete your education and perhaps you do an M-Tech or something, and you might want to do a few more things before you get into this industry, it would have changed. All I'm saying is that when the employers look for a candidate, they see whether the candidate has the basic skills in terms of whatever technology that is, whatever it is. Are they aware of the world that they're stepping into? People think of different things. They become static. There have been many examples in that way. You may not be like that, but log uske bare mein nahi padhte. If I ask you I am asking this class except Dhruval, what are the new areas that are there? What do you see in your area, DCS, the computer technology, 5 years down the line, what are the techs that you think will change? How is the market going to change? Anyone can answer. What are the changes that you expect in the industry? First question is that. Second is, are you ready for it? As graduates, as prospective employees going to join an industry, are you ready for it? What changes do you expect will happen in the next 5 years in technology?
So for the next foreseeable future, close to 5 to 10 years down the line, what I believe is that we are going to like the difference between countries which have adopted to technology and which are doing research at this point in time versus countries like India is going to be humongous. It is going to like exponentially increase. Rather than arithmetic, it would be a geometric stark difference.
Yes.
There is a stark difference, but it is going to increase for the next 10 to 15 years.
And what do you see yourself as a prospective? What do you think that, okay, as a person, as an employer, as a student, where do you first and foremost will be remote working?
We'll have to catch up with them. And close to, like what I believe is close to 10 to 15 years down the line, there would be a decline of those countries. Because at this point in time, they are heading towards something that they shouldn't be heading to. Like it would be a much more detailed answer then. But this is what I believe. Is that they are going to, because third raters at the end of the day would select third raters as their leaders and managers, and those third rated leaders and managers are going to kill those organizations that they themselves have created, be it Google, be it Apple, be it Microsoft, be it Nokia, for an example, a case study maybe 15 years before and today. So that is exactly what is going to happen with Microsoft. It is currently happening with Google and Apple in the foreseeable future. I do believe it's next 10 to 15 years at max that they are surviving.
Yes, correct. Soumya said that work from home could be one of the recent changes. So are you ready for it? This is what employers also look for when they join, when they look for you, when they look for an organization, when they look for a person. They look that whether, yes, are you really ready? do you know about the industry? Do you know about us, the company that you're going to give interview for? Do you know about us? What are we into? Where are we standing in as far as the industry is concerned? जैसे कंप्यूटिंग या सॉफ्टवेयर टेक्नोलॉजी इंडस्ट्री है तो हमारी कंपनी कहाँ खड़ी है, उसे कहाँ जाना चाहिए, वो किस में फॉर एवरी कंपनी हैज गॉट अ स्ट्रॉन्ग पॉइंट. तो क्या वो स्ट्रॉन्ग पॉइंट के साथ जेल आप कर पा रहे हो, क्या आप उसके बारे में जानते हो, आप जहाँ आ रहे हो वो आपको पता है, ये सब चीजें दे वॉन्ट टू नो, दे लुक फॉर दैट व्हेन दे लुक फॉर बिजनेस एंड कमर्शियल अवेयरनेस इन टर्म्स ऑफ व्हाट इज द इंडस्ट्री, वेयर इज इट ग्रोइंग, वेयर डू यू फाइंड योरसेल्फ इन द इंडस्ट्री, एवरीथिंग इज बीन लुक्ड ऑन. दिस इज समथिंग विच इज कॉल्ड एन एम्प्लॉयबिलिटी स्किल. The last one which I'm going to focus on is teamwork, which is again related to this, that it's again human waste, that are you ready to work in a team? You would say yes, definitely. But a team working is not very easy, because you will be working like if in your class or any class. I have got these examples from many classrooms. Whenever I ask people, please form groups, I have seen that people are forming groups from their own close-knit categories. मतलब मेरे बेंच में मेरे साथ बैठा हुआ है मेरा दोस्त है, उसको मैं ग्रुप में बना देता हूँ. इन कंपनीज यू विल नॉट, यू वोंट हैव दैट लक्ज़री, यू विल बी वर्किंग विद डिफरेंट काइंड्स ऑफ पीपल विद डिफरेंट एटीट्यूड्स एंड डिफरेंट काइंड्स ऑफ बिहेवियर्स. सो इन दैट टीम यू आर अ मेंबर, हाउ आर यू गोइंग टू अडैप्ट विद इफ देयर इज अ कॉन्फ्लिक्ट, हाउ आर यू गोइंग टू से कि मैं इस टीम के साथ काम नहीं करूंगा करके भाग आते हो, ये मेरा टीम सड़ी हुई है तो मैं काम नहीं करूंगा, ऐसा है. हाउ डू यू वर्क, देयर इज गोइंग टू बी डिफरेंसेस, देयर आर गोइंग टू बी वर्किंग स्टाइल्स. सो सम पीपल वर्क थ्रू आउट द नाइट. Some people don't want to work throughout the night, they work only during the day. Some people say that hum log aadhe aadhe ghante mein we take a break. Some people say that khatam karo fir uske baad break lete hain, like that. So we'll talk about team building and all those things in detail, that's a part of your syllabus. Okay, we close now because it's already 11:30. Let me talk to you teachers because we need this class. Kyu expert session aaj kyu rakha pata nahi mujhe, but anyway, we'll do that. I've been talking to you about, so this is the larger area, the employability skill framework, which I discussed with you right now. There are trends, which we'll discuss it in the next class or whenever we get time. Maybe in this class itself, this Saturday itself, we will get that. We'll do it. So before we end, for today, I'm going to give you this thing. This link is a kind of a test. I don't take it as a test, it's a brush up of communication skills and several things. There are two writing exercises in it. One is an email, the other is an interview question. So just try attempting that along the way and try to finish it off. We'll see if we can meet today. I definitely want to meet you today so that we can discuss a few more things. But we'll meet and then we'll continue. So as of now, I'm giving you a break because you said you had to go for the expert session. We'll meet later on and continue. Please do make sure that you have done the thing that I gave you. You complete kar dena. This is a link up to a small quiz. As of now, bye and see you. I hope to see you soon. Right? Bye. Thank you.